are playing, and we just can't find the sound.
None of us had the slightest clue as to what it took to act.
Peter's lines were completely redubbed by an actor because you couldn't understand what he was saying.
You don't work with a second act, Devereaux.
I was so low in my chair that I wanted to, like, crawl out of the theater.
There was a scene where Ace is actually an African-American with a wig and white face.
I don't believe it!
By the end of filming, Ace made it very clear that he was leaving the band. And Peter started to feel that way, too. Well, look, don't leave the band. Do a solo record.
Kiss album, because everybody keeps wondering if we're breaking up.
The return of Kiss. The return of Kiss. Don't miss the return of Kiss.
We're talking today with Peter Criss. How does it feel to be away from the group after being with such a successful group for such a long period of time?
I miss the boys, I really do, but I'm extremely happy these days because I think 10 years, I mean, if the Beatles could break up, you know, I could leave something, and I love the Beatles.
Right.
And leaving the band, I thought about it for at least 3 years now. I mean, it wasn't an overnight decision for me.
What's the name of the new drummer?
His name is Eric Carr, and he's incredible.
We're going to see Kiss without their makeup for the very first time. Vinnie Vincent, lead guitarist. Eric Carr, drummer. Paul Stanley, rhythm guitarist and lead vocalist. Gene Simmons, bass.
We went to see Eric when he had his first operation, and we were joking around with him the night before and the night after in the hospital when they opened him up to, he had a heart operation. And he was kidding around, we had a good time. And nobody realized then that it was cancer.
It's a nightmare when you see somebody who's been that close to you and that you've shared so much with dying, you know, and it's a very helpless feeling. All you can do is cheer them on and sincerely tell them that if anybody can beat the odds, you can.
Kiss drummer Eric Carr died of cancer at age 41.
I know that the only way you can carry on is to celebrate what you do and what you do well. And this band has to carry on. It's what it's about. It's in our blood to play music, and I know Eric wouldn't want it any other way.
The band ultimately hired one-time Cult drummer Eric Singer to replace Carr.
Starting to do very bizarre things. They started to have Kiss conventions. They had Kiss tribute bands. And I thought, well, maybe this is what they want. Maybe they want a Kiss convention. When the very first Kiss convention was being put on, one of the magazine editors got a phone call from Peter Criss saying, would Kiss mind if I brought my daughter down?
I said, he should come up and sing. We should get him to come up and play or sing.
Cool when I got up there and did Hard Luck Woman and all that stuff. It was great, man. Everybody was screaming and going crazy. And it was like the old times.
It was very obvious that the fans really got off on seeing Gene, Paul, and Peter together.
Some members of the family here tonight.
They invited us to come do a few songs with them and end off the night.
We're not talking about Mom and Dad.
And the fans went nuts.
We're talking about Peter Criss and Ace Frehley.
Snuck in. Immediately they went, Kiss is here, get out of the way. We were walking backstage. Nobody checked our passes. Nobody stopped us. No cops got in our way. It was like the Red Sea party because Moses hit the rock.
You know how the Grammys used to be, all straight looking folks with suits, everybody looking tired, no surprises. We tired of that. We need something different, something new. We need to shock the people. So let's shock the people.
They called the meeting and they said, hey, we're going to do a reunion tour in makeup with Ace and Peter. And I have to admit, I was shocked.
As soon as it came out of their mouth, this was what I was dealing with for all those years I was in the band. Knowing at some time they'll put the makeup back on.
both Eric and Bruce knew there was no way that we wouldn't do the reunion tour.
We kind of saw the writing on the wall that this reunion tour means that we're not in KISS anymore.
If it were them, they would have done it.
We're going to be trapped in New York City. We get our launch there.
We're four individuals who love what we do and are thrilled to be doing this together again. In the past, we've had our differences, so what? The magic is back.
Live from under the Brooklyn Bridge. You wanted the best, you got the best. It's KISS!
Announced that due to failed contract negotiations, Peter Criss has once again left the band. Taking his place will be Eric Singer, who will be playing in the trademark Catman makeup.
Peter, in my opinion, listened to the wrong advice. He wanted a lot more money than we were willing to talk about. People never talk about money. It is about money. And somebody told him that we wouldn't leave without him, that everything depended on him. It's not true.
This is the KISS Farewell Tour, and it's about celebrating 30 years of KISS. The whole band's history, I'm part of that history, but also there's four really strong identifiable characters that I think everybody identifies with. Played in a version of KISS before, be able to get to play in makeup with KISS to me is like the ultimate.
I'm Tommy Thayer, it's lead guitarist in a big rock band called KISS. I'm not an original member. I'm